One of the most overlooked features is the Photoshop Quick Mask tool. You can use the Photoshop Quick Mask mode to create and edit selections quickly. Start with a selection and then add to or subtract from it to make the mask. You can also create the mask entirely in Quick Mask mode. The color differentiates the protected and unprotected areas. I'm going to start with an initial selection and create a new layer. And I'm going to use the Select Subject button up here at the top of the menu bar. And Photoshop does a pretty good job of selecting everything, the camera, the strap. Sometimes it's hard to see all of the selection. It's hard to visualize it. You see the marching ants, but sometimes it's hard to see in detail where it's actually selecting. So the Quick Mask mode is accessed down here on the bottom left of your toolbar. And you can click in the middle of the circle, and the circle's filled in, and that means you're in the Quick Mask mode. I'm gonna click off there to turn off the Quick Mask mode, and you can also press down on the Q key on your keyboard. Let's look at some of the Quick Mask options. So if you double click on your Quick Mask mode icon here, here are the Quick Mask options. It says color indicates, and if I click on mask areas and say okay, this shows you that the selected areas are white, or you can see the camera completely, and the mask area in this case is red, and that is something that you can change yourself. I double click on this again and click on the option selected areas. The selected area is going to use this red color. So if I say okay and hit Q on the keyboard, now it's showing me that my selected area is the color red, and the mask area outside of it is white. And you can change this color and the opacity. Sometimes you might want to change this color if it makes the selection look easier. So if you click on it, you can use the color picker and change the color and say okay. Most times I use red and the opacity at 50%. So both the color and the opacity settings affect only the appearance of the mask and have no effect on how the underlying areas are protected. So changing these settings make the mask more easily visible against the colors in the image. We're going to leave the options at selected areas, the color red, and the opacity of 50%, and say okay. You can toggle between the mask areas and the selected areas options for Quick Mask by holding down your Alt or Option key and clicking on the Quick Mask mode button. There's our mask area option, and here's our selected area option. Let's go with the selected area option. Back to our selection we made with the Select Subject tool. I'm going to zoom in here and just for a second get out of Quick Mask mode. And using the Quick Mask mode in this scenario is very helpful, because here Photoshop made a very good selection, but back here on the edges there is an area where it missed because there isn't much contrast between the camera and the background. Same over here, area of this cap and up here on the top of this mode switch on this camera. And yes, you can use other tools like the pen tool, but if you don't want to use that and you just want to quickly select something, this is the way to go. So again, I'll go into Quick Mask mode by hitting the Q key, and I'm going to use my brush, B for the brush tool. I'm going to make my brush small, zoom in, and keep my hardness around 50%, make it a little bit smaller. Over here, my color swatch as black as being my foreground color, and I'm going to paint this area in. And as you can see, going over that area, if I hit the Q key again, you can see that my selection has been updated. Same thing over in this area here, you can see at the top of this camera, very faintly, there's more to the camera that did not get selected. So again, Q for the quick mode, and I'm just painting in the areas that it did not select. And I could put my brush at one point, hold down the shift key and get a straighter line. And same for down here, you can see where it missed. I press down the Q key, you can see where my selections have been updated. Again, I have a soft brush and I'm just painting in the areas where I can fine tune my selection, because the Quick Mask mode allows you to get in there and really refine your selection. Like I said, you can use the pen tool for all this, but if you don't like using it, this is a good alternative too. Now in here, maybe it got too much. I can hit an X to change my paint color and paint in white right here, because I don't want that selected. The Q key again, and see it updated my selection. Now that I've refined my selection, I can hit Q again. I'm out of the quick mask mode. I can hit my add new layer mask icon and I've created my layer mask. If you're getting value out of this so far, hit that like button. You can, of course, use quick mask mode to actually make the selection. In other words, you can use this without using one of the selection tools in Photoshop. Let me show you that. So make sure that your default colors of the color swatch down here is black and white. You can hit a D to set the default colors to black and white and hit an X to toggle your color swatch. So now if I hit Q, notice my layer in the layers panel is red. That means I'm in quick mask mode and I'm going to use my brush tool and I'm going to select black as my foreground color and just paint over this cap. And I'm going to make this go faster. And I'm painting here and the red is selecting all the areas of the cap. And I'm gonna go through this quickly. And if I press Q again, you see that it is selected. So you can use the quick mask mode without actually using a selection tool. So if you're looking to learn more Photoshop tips and tricks, check out one of the videos on the screen now. If you like this video and would like to see more, consider giving us a like and even subscribing if you haven't already. And remember, it's never too late to learn. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.